morning, Soraya.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing okay. It's been a tough week, but I'm doing good. And I'm glad we're into fall, my favorite season of the year. So.
Oh my gosh, yeah. So happy fall. What is that, equinox? Yeah.
And
the autumnal equinox.
And in my valley, I don't know about your valley, but we've got beautiful blue skies, as your shirt demonstrates, Mr. Blue Sky. From the show that we went to see together.
Yes. That was at
Hollywood Bowl.
Yeah. We saw ELO with the great Jeff Lynn.
Yes. So it's probably no surprise what we're going to be talking about today, is it?
Well, it's a surprise to me.
I hope it's not.
So why don't you tell everyone what we're talking about today?
So we're continuing to go through the box set Nuggets that was released by Rhino Records, the 4-disc set. And we're going disc by disc, and we're up to disc number 3, Soraya. So disc number 3. So before we get started, generally speaking, what do you think about this disc?
To me, this was the more distinct so far, and a lot more. I found the tracks to be a little more experimental, you know, lots of fuzz, you know, which I absolutely love. And one of my tracks has, you know, highlights of Farfisa. I mean, there's just lots of fun sounds on this, and I liked it.
Same. Yeah.
What about you?
Yeah, I really liked it quite a bit. I think it's even a little bit stronger than disc 2. And there's so many good songs on all of these discs. I mean, this is another CD with a lot of tracks, 30 tracks on disc 3.
Yeah.
So we have lots to choose from, a lot of under 3-minute songs. great psychedelic pop songs.
And then I just want to add on to that. Many times, or at least me, and I take responsibility for my opinion, I think of psychedelic songs as being psychedelic prog songs that go on forever. You know, it's just like one long tune. And to me, it's mind-boggling that we get these really poignant psychedelic songs with all the psychedelic sounds in under 3 minutes.
Yep.
I don't know how they do it, but hats off to every single one of these bands on these discs so far, because I don't know how you do it.
Yeah, but I think this is a very exciting disc, and I think we should jump into it because I'm excited to hear what you've picked.
Let's go.
Hi, this is Soraya.
And this is Jeff.
Our podcast is called Paisley Stage Raspberry and Rhyme.
A podcast where the two of us play music that we like and share anecdotes and background about the tunes.
We hope you'll join our conversation. And without further ado, a groovear.
Let's get groovy. All right, disc 3. I say we jump into it with one of your picks.
Okay, so my first pick, and I want to just play it and then we can talk about it, is a band called The Rationals. And the song's called I Need You.
But if you ever tell me goodbye, I'll break down and you'll hear me cry. needs you more than anybody else has needed anyone before. More than anybody else has needed anyone before. I need you, I need you, I need you.
Thanks, Raya. We just jumped straight into the psychedelic party right there.
Isn't that a great tune?
It is. I love that one.
What's interesting is, so many of you may have recognized that that's a Ray Davies tune. This is a Kinks cover. And I just liked it from the start. Great guitars. I really like Scott Morgan's vocals on this. Just there's something very earthy and very soulful about it. I just liked it from the get-go. And, you know, just that driving guitar, perfect. And yeah, and you got all that cool psychedelic sounds. Couple of just tidbits. This is an Ann Arbor, Michigan band. So shout out to Ann Arbor. But some little tidbits. The band really, I think, liked this title because they sang another song later on that didn't get as much traction. Apparently it was a number 5 hit in Michigan, so it was a regional hit, called I Need You, but it was a Jerry Goffin Carol King song.
Oh, wow.
So I'm like, okay, I don't think you could have two more diverse songwriters and styles, but, and just one little thing, the vocalist, Scott Morgan, he was asked to join Blood, Sweat, and Tears at one point. And
whoa.
He turned it down.
Wow.
Okay, that's, I don't know. That's pretty cool. So some of the stuff I've read about the band, you know, they really liked things with a soul vibe, because they even did a cover of Otis Redding, Respect.
Oh.
Very early on. So this is a band that had like a really nice breath of influences. I really liked it. And one last detail. In 2009, a 2-CD anthology of the Rationals' hits of their mid-60s phase got released in 2009. And then in 2010, they were voted to the Michigan Michigan Rock and Roll Legends Online Hall of Fame. So definitely respected and endeared in Michigan, but I love this song. So that was my first one. All right, so Jeff, tell us your first pick.
Okay, my first pick is a song called Fight Fire by a band called The Gollywogs. And there are some similarities between the two songs that I picked. Both originated out of California. Both bands originated out of California, Southern California even.
Yeah.
Both songs are angry songs about getting burned by girls. So the Fight Fire, the singer's talking about, I'm going to fight fire with fire, girl. So both are, yeah, angry songs. So those are the connections between my two this week. Fight Fire, the song by the Gollywogs, was actually their 6th single. Another connection between my two bands, which seems to not be that uncommon, is that they were primarily a singles band. So neither band released albums except when it came to the compilation, like you discussed with the Rationals. So that later on CD, all the singles were combined to make a compilation release. So, but they never recorded a full length album. But the Gollywogs started off in El Cerrito, California. Two brothers, Tommy and John, not Tommy John, but Tommy and John, got together and they started a band. They were originally called the Blue Velvets, Soraya, and then they got picked up by Fantasy Records, and their label, Fantasy Records, changed their name, unbeknownst to them, to the Gollywogs, and they hated the name the Gollywogs. So, but they kept it for all 7 of their singles. And then after releasing their 7th single, they decided, we're going to change our name. We hate this name, the Gollywogs. And they changed their name to Creedence Clearwater Revival. So John Fogerty and his brother Tommy started this band. Originally, Tommy wrote all their hit singles, and then as they went along, John started to write more of their songs, and they became Creedence Clearwater Revival, who we all know and love. So Fight Fire, as you'll listen, it sounds a lot like Gloria, a lot. Even the solo sounds a lot like it. But anyways, this is one, their original, Fight Fire, and I just think it's a great song. Both of my songs have a R&B punk 60s feel to it. 2.5 minutes of pure bliss for me. So this is the Gollywogs doing Fight Fire. Shakers. So their compilation that they released with all of the singles was called Pre-Credence by the Gollywogs. So pretty creative there to call it Pre-Credence, but I'm sure they're pandering to the Creedence Clearwater Revival fan base.
Damn, that's good. But John Gollywogs, yeah, I would have changed that too.
Yeah, they didn't like that name. That was their label.
It sounds so campy, and their vibe is very different.
Yeah. So anyways, I thought that was kind of cool.
I love it. Tommy, old Tommy and John.
From El Cerrito, California.
There you go.
El Cerrito High School.
Woohoo!
All right. What you got next, Soraya?
All right. So next I decided to stay local and I picked an LA band.
Okay.
That like to dress all in black.
Oh.
They're called The Music Machine, and my pick is Double Yellow Line.
Down.
Those keyboards.
Oh my gosh, those drums, man, and that fuzzy distorted guitar. Mwah! So this band is from LA. They so there was a trio. They were called the Ragamuffins. Ragamuffins evolved into, by adding two more people, they involved into the Music Machine. And they used to play gigs all dressed in black, and people hated it. Hated it. Like, but that was kind of their thing. And what I like about the Music Machine, people may know a previous hit by them, which is called Talk Talk.
Oh, yeah.
But I like Double Yellow Line because you get all these cool psychedelic influences and just fun stuff in the song. And the vocals, man, the vocals are pretty wild. And so I read something that said that Sean Bonnywell, I have to make sure I say his name right. Sean Bonnywell. That it's his vocals. Okay, wait. I just want you to hear this because I love your thoughts. His vocals. So Bonnywell's progressive lyrics and arrangements. Sorry, it wasn't his vocals, it was the arrangements, have been credited with influencing the Doors and Iron Butterfly, oh, as well as future punk bands. So one of the things about Music Machine that people, that some have written about, is that they're kind of a first step to punk.
Whoa.
Now, I don't, you know, I think it's an interesting theory and one I'd like to explore a little more. But the point of one writer was, this is a band that does a little more than other garage bands, because they have a say and are a bit more preoccupied with the lyrical arrangement and the musical arrangement. So, and they start doing different things, like they bought one thing I read was they bought hardware to make their own fuzz switch.
Wow.
So I'm like, okay, so these are guys that were looking for a sound that they couldn't find, or maybe that they wanted to create on their own. So I found that really, really interesting.
That is
cool. But I want you to listen to this. So Talk Talk was a major single, and then Double Yellow B-side. But listen to this. So after the release of Talk Talk, they go on a 3-month tour across the US, listen to this, with the Beach Boys, Question Mark and the Mysterians, and Clyde McFadder. That is like a wild combo. And then they come back and they release their debut album, Turn On the Music Machine. And then they start kind of getting some traction, and then the band falls apart because of I read something that managerial and financial disputes.
Uh-oh.
So the band fragments. Sean Bonnywell then takes a lineup and calls it Bonnywell's Music Machine. but everything goes boop in 1969. But you just go, man. Really interesting. And there are appearances on TV shows from the time, like Shindig, American Bandstand, of Where the Action Is. But just a cool band. Nice. Really interesting sound. So I was here for it. All right, Jeff, we're gonna close it with you. And I do want people to pay attention to this second pick. Jeff and I once again shared brain synapses, because his picks were mine. Oh. So I just kept going down the list. It's okay. All right, Jeff, what's your second pick?
So we're going to travel from LA down to my area. So this band, the lyrics are from North San Diego County. So from the Oceanside, Carlsbad, Cardiff area, not too far from where my office is, actually, the band started. So they say it started in Oceanside. The song is called So What? And I was reading a little bit about the song, and the singer, Chris Gaylord, who also plays harmonica on the song, said that it was one of those songs where he got burned by a rich girl. So she invited him over to her house, and she had, Soraya, she had two refrigerators. That's how rich she was. And not only that, she had an electric typewriter. So this girl was balling, right?
Ew.
So he was trying to make some moves with this girl, and she shut him down, and that was it for him. And so he got so upset, he went home and he wrote So What? So this song is So What by the Lyrics. They came out of not too far from my work. They only released a handful of singles, not even enough to make a compilation. So all you get is the singles and various compilations, such as the Nuggets with this track. And they did appear a couple times on a San Diego show. I think it was called Night Dance Time or something like that. The Dance Time Show, San Diego Dance Time Show. So song came out in 1965. And it's funny because in one of the videos that you can find on YouTube, of them performing was filmed at the Oceanside Community Center, so not far from where I work. So local boys, they only lasted a few years. Like I said, they only put out a handful of singles. Started in 65, by 68 they were gone. I thought it was interesting that the connection between my two were angry guys that girls didn't fall for them. So it was the inspiration for songs. So yeah, I like this one quite a bit. Another one of those R&B songs. They pull out the harp or mouth harp or harmonica, what have you. And it's just a really fun song. And how has there not been another band name with the Lyrics, right? I mean, such a generic name. But anyways, let's give it a listen. Last song for us today from the Nuggets by the Lyrics, So What?
Oh,
think that may be the first song that shouts out an electric typewriter. Right. Yeah. I don't know, I could be wrong.
I think you're right. I mean, a little butthurt, are we?
Hey, man. Never question people's feelings. He was hurt.
Yeah.
He said, so what?
Yeah.
I don't care about your electric typewriter, girl.
Yeah, that one cracks me up. So interesting fact about this song, the single was reissued this year by a label in the UK, Ace Records. So they re-released the 7-inch single in 2021. And Chris Gaylord, the singer, went on to front a band called Magic Mushroom in 67. So
do you have it?
I don't. No, but I'd like to hunt that one down. Oh, and what's the B-sides called? They Can't Hurt Me. So
see, I'm a rock. I'm an island.
Yeah, so fun song. And I forgot to mention on your Double Yellow Line, as we were listening to it, I totally got a Tom Jones kind of vibe on your song. So I could kind of hear a young Tom Jones kind of swagger.
That voice is pretty wild.
Music machine, that was great. Yeah.
Okay, Jeff, if I had to push you, okay, to give me at least one honorable mention.
Oh.
One song that you didn't pick, but that you really enjoy.
Yeah, there was a few. Run, Run, Run by the Gestures was another one that I was thinking of picking too. But there are so many great songs on here on this disc three. A couple that I thought people would be more likely to have heard, like some guys, Sometimes Good Guys Don't Wear White by the Standells, which I've heard on the radio quite a bit. I really liked Psycho by the Sonics. I think that's a great one. There's a Sir Douglas Quintet song that's really great.
Yes.
The Lime and Spell song,
Song is so good.
Warren Zevon, right? I think that's a Warren Zevon track, if I'm not mistaken. And then Ted Nugent appears on this one, as on the previous one, with his band Amboy Dukes. So.
And that song, it's the last one on this disc.
It closes it
out. Journey to the Center of the Mind. It is a wild song. It is. And I remember thinking to myself, this cannot be the one and same Ted Nugent. But it is. But let me tell you, my honorable mention, The Balloon Farm, A Question of Temperature.
Oh,
that song kicks ass. Also, the E-Types, put the clock back on the wall.
Oh yes, yeah.
The Music Explosions, a little bit of soul.
Yes,
but
dun, dun, dun,
dun. Dun, dun, dun. And then but the one song that I know I've heard often, and I don't know how often other people have, is that lead off track by Los Hombres, called Let It Out, Let It All Hang Out.
Let It All Hang Out, yeah.
This three, I think, has a great variety of songs and influences, and, you know, just think like, Let It Out, Let It All Hang Out, and the last track is Amboy Dukes. You know, you get a lot on this particular disc, so. Those are, Jeff and I just gave you four of our picks, but there are 30 bloody songs on this disc, which Rhino was kind enough to put together.
Yes.
And not a bum one in the lot. So
I'd say so, yeah. I'd say so with this disc. And then we'll finish up next week with disc number four. More great tracks. So
wow.
We got to start listening and narrowing down, Soraya.
Okay. So mi gente, agroviar.
Groove on, Paisley people.